Walking briskly down the halls of the Ohio State Wexner Medical Center is an easy task now for George Kosta. But that wasn't always the case. The 65-year-old developed idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis, a chronic disease that leads to lung failure. In May of 2016, George's name was added to the lung transplant list, but it took 16 weeks of waiting before suitable lungs were found.
By the time I needed a transplant, I was dying. I was almost dead.
Yet George's faith and family kept him going.
During the time period, sure, I was down at times or I was up, and he went through a lot to get me to where I was. And you need family. If you don't have a wife that's going to take care of you and a son that's going to be there and neighbors that are going to help you, if you don't have those things, I don't know how people get through some of this.
Finding suitable lungs for transplant is no easy task. Lungs are a delicate organ, and finding viable lungs suitable for transplant can be difficult. But at Ohio State's Comprehensive Transplant Center, research has led to a process called ex vivo lung perfusion, which basically cleans the lungs. Removing excess fluid and inflammation in the lung tissue repairs unsuitable lungs for transplant, giving more patients, like George, the opportunity for a second chance. In fact, George was the first patient at Ohio State to receive lungs that went through the ex vivo perfusion process.
The doctor came in and said, "We got a problem. You opted for the ex vivo perfusion process. Are you okay with that? If not, these lungs are no good." Okay, what choices are there? So that's why I didn't even think about it. Yes, let's go.
And today, George is 100% back into life. He has regular checkups at Ohio State to make sure the lungs stay healthy and that the lungs are providing the oxygen he needs.
There was a time 2 years ago I'd get halfway up the hill and stop. And you know, I walk up, I'm a little winded, but it's a normal, you know, winded. And I can walk up that hill and walk back down the hill and walk back up the hill if I had to. I can do a lot.
That includes riding his motorcycle again. Doctors gave George the thumbs up last spring. And now that he's retired, George is truly enjoying his new life. George is also thankful. Thankful he was given a second chance.
I never lost sight of one thing. Somebody donated these lungs. My donor was a 17-year-old kid who had committed suicide. That got to me. The young man's donations helped up to 100 people. So not only his organs, but I guess maybe grafts and stuff like that. So he was able to touch his dad, said 100 people. I'm a blessed man. Lucky, say what you want, but I'm a blessed man. And, you know, God, family, and friends. And that's how we got through all of that.